A stream of people getting tested for COVID-19 at Melbourne's Altaqua College, a vaccination centre set up alongside after a teacher somehow contracted the virus.
So it's really impressive that they have set it up so quickly, within like maybe within 24 hours.
Authorities are racing to suppress two separate Delta outbreaks that prompted Victoria's seven-day lockdown.
Victoria is in a precarious position when it comes to where this particular series of outbreaks are at the moment.
New cases out in the community while infectious include another relative of the teacher from southwestern Melbourne. Three others are linked to a worker at a warehouse in the city's west, including his housemate, a cleaner at Richmond's Epworth Hospital.
An out-of-hours admin area's only cleaner requires no further furloughing of staff.
While another school added to the list of exposure sites. Last night's snap lockdown triggered a protest, hundreds gathering in Melbourne's CBD in a matter of hours.
The focus and the opprobrium here absolutely needs to be on this hardcore violent element who are taking this opportunity to come out and duke it out with the police.
A $400 million package jointly funded by the state and federal government's been announced to support almost 100,000 businesses.
Which is above and beyond what we've been able to do in the past, and that's only possible as a consequence of that Commonwealth contribution.
Automatic payments of $2,800 will be made to a range of businesses, including cafes, hairdressers and gyms. There'll also be payments of between $5,000 and $20,000 to licensed venues based on their capacity.
The truth is, it'll never be enough to cover the money that's been lost by business through it. We hope it's enough to get businesses through the next 7 days so that they can open up and trade again.
An entertainment group due to perform at five weddings this weekend, among businesses blindsided.
There was a bride that was supposed to get married this Sunday. She's postponed four times.
It's just part of the ongoing difficulty of managing those competing interests in the middle of a pandemic.
Disappointment and frustration at yet another lockdown, combined with hope that it will work. Philippa Carisbrook, SBS World News.